Hey. Yeah. I should really turn off my sound on my stream here. How's everyone doing? I wanted to get live at 9 a.m. and it's 9:20, so that's not too bad. I have my breakfast here. All right. I suppose I should turn on my rig. And I need to connect my probe. Hi, Quick Mew. Yeah, so inspired by the 2500K result this week, which is insane, 6.3 something, I thought I would also try LN2 on, well, Sandy on LN2. But I don't think this chip will do as well as this. I think I binned three 2600Ks, and this is the best one. It does the 56x malt on water, and I've been for 2500Ks, and I also found a 26x malt chip there. So, and I need to update my, before I forget, I need to update my rig details. How's everyone doing? Still bored at home? This croissant is pretty good. Oh, I think the rig details are actually correct. Well, that's a nice surprise. I think I should just be able to. No, it reset because I changed the CPU. I had the 3770K on here. I'm gonna load the profile, but I obviously need to reduce multiplier, CLK. Oh, that's a hang. Well, I hope it doesn't apply the volts. Okay. Hi, Snoop Dogg. Okay, that was a bit of a crazy moment. I thought it might have applied 1.9 volts. Daryl, how are you doing? Well, hopefully I won't have the slowest 32M in the world. Okay, so let's just make a new profile then. So we want all core. Ugh. Let's say 30x all core, 100 BCLK, spread spectrum off, speed step off, turbo voltage auto, PLL over voltage on, power limit to the max, all power limits, all current limits to the max. We're not going to be clocking the iGPU. DRAM just the lowest, doesn't really matter. Auto everything. Extreme voltage on. Switching frequency max. Current is the highest. Fixed CPU, but we'll go, 1.35 or something. LLC on. Let's go level 2. DRAM. Whatever, 1.7. I don't really care. Two cores, hyper-threading off, all power saving features off. Yeah, I do have LN2. Actually quite a lot of it, as you can see here. One full Duo here and one sort of half full Duo behind me. But hopefully not going to be using everything today. Okay, I think we're starting to get to a state where we may be able to boot. Debug LED I wanted on at all times. On OC formulas, the debug the default setting for debug LEDs tends to be that it's off once you're booting into OS, which makes you sometimes think that you're not booting, so I don't want that. Suspend to RAM off, HPT off. Sorry, had to just suppress the sneeze there. I have allergies, so. Secure boot off. We don't want to monitor. What don't we want to monitor? Overtemp off. Okay, I clearly need to save stuff and like. Yeah, this board is a bit wonky, I have to say. I need to just slowly save stuff. Hello, monitor. Please come back. Three G all core. Yeah, I'll just do one sub menu at a time, basically. So what's your best score, Daryl, so far? Or maybe worst score? Let's try LLC2. Just wanna lock in the frequency as well and the DRAM voltage. Okay, I'll save that as a profile and reboot and then do more. 2600K. Two. I should hook up my probe as well. All right, still 25 degrees on the probe, so no need to worry about pouring. We want to set the BCLK explicitly. And here we go again, the same dance as before. I think it actually likes the black ports. I need to switch around my SSD as well. Whatever the fuck smart connectors. Where was debug led? Okay. Think that's worth saving again. Hi, Hardware Barbecue. Okay. Don't know if I should enable LN2 mode. I'm probably going to be at very low temperatures. Double checking these. Where's all the it's on the South Bridge, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, I'll turn these off and then I'll do one boot just to detect hardware and stuff because I previously ran 3770K on here. This chip did 56 on ambient. But very often they don't scale. So this is the validation I got on it on Chiller. Making sure that my rapid OC works for multiplier and BCLK and voltage. Right, we'll restart later, don't worry. Don't worry, Windows. Okay, BCLK is working. Now let's try ratio. I'm gonna have to do I nope. Okay, something went wrong with voltage, but I think I can just set voltage in the BIOS. That shouldn't be a problem. Oh well. Keep, you're a star. Thanks for all the gifted subs. Okay, let me just get a fan on the rig and attach the heater. And then I'm just gonna pour some LN2, I guess. on annoying camera. All right. Need to make. Why does it keep hanging? I don't really get it. So the probe is showing plus 30 at the moment. Sorry about my sniffling. I have allergies, so do you have an excuse, I suppose? I'm liking the shot, but we need to get the alien in the frame. Heater is on. Maybe I can put him on the side here. I'm gonna go to about minus 20, I suppose. These chips very often don't scale, so my expectations are very low. And what's this crap? Is it cold bug already? Give it a few attempts. Minus 3 right now, but it didn't apply, so I don't know. I mean, yeah, it didn't apply. So what's so special about this setting? Let's just try again. Going into BIOS. No, I didn't apply. Okay. I mean, let's see if it's the voltage. I don't know. So that seemed to work. Minus 11 at the moment. It's hanging on 62 for some reason. Let's go 1.6 and auto BCLK. Sometimes it's funky with memory is at 33, 33, so maybe I should just set a memory to auto, to be honest. I could also try two sticks. Let's go auto memory then. Okay. Auto memory 45 multiplier. Let's see what happens. Yeah, but maybe it's just not happy with 999. I go 912 9 on this PSC. Just double checking that it's really PSC. That should do. Yeah, it keeps on throwing 55. What I'll do is I'll disable LN2 mode and all that crap. But I'm not memory overclocking at the moment. That's what the point I'm trying to make is that I'm not overclocking the memory at the moment. It shouldn't matter what stick is in there. Okay, so I have loose timings now. And two mode is off. Maybe just not liking single channel. I'll put in a second stick. Yep. Who knows? Who knows what these old chips like? Oh yeah, that's it. I cleared CMOS. I'm just going to build a completely new profile for cold. Okay, here we go again. All core. BCLK on auto. Spectrum off. I'm getting good at this, I reckon. Just auto everything on the down here, basically. I do want to load a regular profile though. That I think that might be important. Add E on everything. Let's just see what happens with that. Maybe a stick is dead. Are dying. See, that works, so I don't really get it. I do need to disable some of these things though. Just want to keep on doing reboots at minus 20 to make sure it's not an IMC issue at this temperature. So now it's happy all of a sudden. Okay. We already did that, so just don't want driver crap coming up. And actually the other thing I'll do is make sure I can set CPU voltage safely without getting 5.5 again. So let's see. Hmm. 5.5. Weird. Well, let's load the profile and see if that fixes it. Okay. Well, by process of elimination, I mean, we can... just have a look. It's not the onboard devices, surely. Let's check that out. And debug led. It's very unlikely it's those. Yeah, that's fine. So it is really CPU voltage that's making it throw 55. Someone try and work that one out. Honestly, I don't get it. Or maybe it's the I mean, I can try and set it in OS. Let's see how high we can go on multiplier without setting the voltage. Not very high, apparently. All right, I'll just clear CMOS, load the profile, and go into OS and see if I can set volts there. This board is a bit funny though. It doesn't really like clocking multiplier if you don't set multiplier 50 or above in BIOS. So let's see. At least it's not cold bugging at minus 20. That's already something. Let's see if we have both channels. Maybe there's something funky going on with the AMC. We do have dual channel. Timings did set. Okay. Let's go to 1.5. Hang. Really weird. That's so weird. It's the same bias I used to get this result on Ambien as well. So, let's see if fixed mode is what's making it fail. Okay, at least I can set fixed mode. I can't set a voltage via fixed mode, but I can at least set that. Okay. I mean, weird. That's all I can say. Let's see. I mean, maybe we can just raise it slowly, you know? Maybe we can go to 1.25. That's something. Okay, so 1.35. Azrock is just a champ at making weird biases. And now it's hanging on 63. I don't really get it. We can try like LN2 mode or something, or enable all cores. I mean, I've set all the current limits, so, and it's only on two cores, so. Okay, here we go, LN2 mode. Okay, smaller steps. 1.4 is okay. We're starting to get to a range that is actually somewhat useful and not just a complete and utter fucking joke. 1.4 seems all right. 4.25. Ooh, maybe it was LN2 mode that was required. Might be a little bit too cold now. It was hanging on the entering bias step. And it's on minus 30 or so. But that's okay, we can let it get warmer again. Clear the CMOS. Could always reflash the BIOS or something just to be completely certain about it. I mean, I'm not doing something stupid here. CPU voltage really is V core, isn't it? Let's set this secondary plane crap just in case. Yeah. Okay, let's just boot this to OS. At about minus 25. I'm not surprised. Sandy E was just as much of a fuck around as this. Seems like more of a board issue though. On my Maximus 4 and 5 boards, I have various hardware issues though, so I don't really want to switch to that. I have a second OC formula. That's an option, I suppose. Yeah, it's just refusing to set voltage. I just don't get it. Right, I'm going to the downloads page. Oh, there's 50x. 52? No. Oh, well, it needs more. It needs more than that. Well, what we can also do is we can check for, well, checking for Kolbug is kind of meaningless if you're going to set a completely different V core later on, so. Now, where's my BIOS USB stick? I'll be sorry to see my profiles go, but I think ASRock actually keeps profiles between flashes. Maybe on, not on old boards like this, but. I might just flash the backup BIOS actually. That's a better idea. I can flash across. I think there's an option to flash across main to backup. I think. It's been a while. My second BIOS is corrupted for some reason at the moment. Minus 20. Flashing a BIOS, just, you know, ordinary everyday things. Exciting stuff. At least I'm not burning through LN2. Yeah, ASRock, I had a really bad time on ASRock on FM2 with weird like cold bugs, cold boot bugs, just can't set, similar to this actually, can't set vCore above a certain thing, and it's just bullshit. What I might actually do just out of paranoia as well is connect the second 8-pin. Well, there's an 8-pin and a 4-pin, so I'm connecting an 8-pin, but it's going to be in 4-pin mode because of the way this board is set up. Yeah, connect the 8-pin, just fresh BIOS profile. Like, there's not much else I can do, really. I mean, especially in LN2 mode, I should be able to blast volts on this. So, connecting the pin. Okay. As we lose all the viewers, since there's no overclocking going on, but that's nothing new for my stream, is it? Okay, what I literally do is I will literally only set CPU voltage to 1.5. Hanging on 62. It's not even an older BIOS on the website, is there? Well, what I'll do is I'll just go to like a 1.42G or whatever. I'll just go to a completely different BIOS, because I was running this on, I was running 1.55 volts on ambient on the same BIOS. So apparently there is sound. Maybe you just need an old bias for Sandy. But I just don't get it because look here. Validation. This exact fucking board. Said 77 OC formula P2.3. The same bias. I mean, I do have a backup board, but do I really want to be tearing down? This could be some sort of advanced cold bug, you know? A voltage cold bug. So yeah, White Shark, you were asking about LN2. My LN2 guy does deliver. He doesn't have very many pub clients and stuff, so he's actually, his business is still doing okay. So he has, you know, hospitals and plumbers and like fiber optic businesses and things like that, and they all didn't shut down, so apparently. So yeah, and he wears a mask, wipes down the handles and the lids of the viewers and stuff. And I stayed socially distanced, so no worries. Okay, I'll do the same thing. I'll keep all cores on. I'll up the current limits and try to set like 1.5 V-core. I could understand why like 1.8 wouldn't work. I think that's definitely on Sandy, that would be a board dependent thing, you know, being able to push insane volts. But 1.5 V-core. Are you fucking kidding me? People run that on air daily. Ooh, a different colored ASRock icon. Nice. Taking longer. Okay, so what we're going to do is what's with all these hangs and bias? I don't get it. Maybe you're just at a bad temperature. Let's try like minus 50 or something. Okay, power saving disabled, extreme voltage on, current threshold the highest, switching frequency the highest, CPU voltage fixed, 1.5 volts. Oh, 78. Are we too cold? All right, let's try switch the backup bias. In case the bias chip is fucked or something. Maybe I can, hi Firekiller. Welcome, welcome. I think, well, are you Phil or Stavros? One of the OGS guys. In any case, welcome to my stream. Right now we're at minus 40. Okay, so I think it's flashing from the front, from the first bias onto the second bias. So we can now check a different bias chip. Hi, Savros. So, trying to clock Sandy on LN2 and failing miserably. Not really running into any code boot bug issues, but kind of suspecting that the board is, or the chip is, acting kind of funky on cold. The problem is, I'm not able to set higher than 1.5 vCore. No matter what power savings features I disable or whatever. So I'm just trying the second BIOS chip instead because I've already reflashed the first chip and it didn't help. So maybe the BIOS chip is just screwed. But otherwise, yeah, I might have to swap to my 2500K. I also have a backup board, but especially on a freshly flashed BIOS, if the board can't do cold on Sandy, what good is it anymore? I was expecting these kind of issues though, so it's all good. At least my internet isn't crapping out like last week. Touch wood. Fingers crossed. That's what I think about this whole situation. Keeps hanging for some reason. Okay. Yeah. All right. I knew this was gonna happen. I'm swapping to the 25K. Actually, first things first, I'm gonna try to bench at like minus 10. Because actually, that's where I got my best results on Sandy E, so. Okay, one more quick attempt at disabling absolutely all current related, No, it's hanging again. All right, minus seven. Let's go. But the only thing that in practice actually should, it's hanging again. Okay, different chip, same board is what I'm gonna try. $2,500K, 3 of 4. The other three have been sold, so this is gonna be the magic one. I mean, people have run chips on single stage on this board. So it's not that it's completely incompatible with Sandy. I refuse to believe that. Hi, Bulant. How are you doing? How are things over there in Western Australia? An Irish ditty, I don't even know what that means. Just checking to see if it posts. All right, other board it is then. Now that's right, this board maybe doesn't like CMOS battery out, so I'll try that again. People keep telling me that Z77 OC formulas die a lot. I'm starting to believe them. maybe it's just wet, but it was throwing 0-0. Let's keep the battery out and dry it. This is what I prepared earlier. Like a cooking show. Seems to be posting. Yeah, something's going on. All right. Let's attach our LN2 goodies. This better be it because I don't have a third board. So Daryl called it, different board, Indifferent chip. Ah, yeah. Don't know. Don't know which I should do, 2500K or 2600K, to be honest. What if the 2600K just has. Okay. I'm skeptical because this is literally the same board. Would be really weird. But to be fair, one thing that speaks in favor is the fact that this is the board I used for the ambient results. So maybe it really is a board issue. Okay. Last chance for this chip. Otherwise, it's getting sold. Who here wants a 5.6G ambient 2600K? Gonna give the sounds like a good chip. Yeah, it's gonna give the pot a little bit of a clean. It's my T-Rex. Isn't that beautiful? T-Rex is such a good. The only thing is, the other day I was trying to run 3770K direct die on the OC formula, and because the base is so wide, actually with direct die the pot sits a little bit lower, it actually was hitting caps on this board. So compatibility isn't amazing on the T-Rex because it's so wide, but once you can get it on the board, it is just unbelievable. It take doesn't take long to pull down, but it still takes a bit big heat load. It's easy to pour into because it's wide. Come on. We're not running full pot here, so the paste won't matter. Okay.
How did I get a knot into my bloody thermal probe? This is the boring bit.
Probe is showing plus 18. All seems sensible. Yeah, it's showing CPU light, so not a good sign. But I posted once. That's the CPU light. And it should be off. Do I really want to mount again? Okay, 2500K it is then. What boards did you buy, Phil? Seems like the outside slots weren't working. The 2500K does about 5640, I think. So this was the 2600K, and so 5620. And no, wrong one. Where's 2500K? Yeah. Oh, I remember that well. 5640, I said, and it did 5639. All right. It did 56 mult as well, but I just was able to get a little bit more frequency at 55 with BCLK. Now I'm tempted to put the 2600K back in again with the other RAM slots. Okay, it was the RAM slots. They both, so Phil, I mentioned this earlier in the stream, but I went through three 2600Ks and four 2500Ks, and these were the only ones that did the 56 multiplier. I think the others did like 51 and 53. So I have one of each that does 56 multiplier. I want to try and set 1.5 V core. I'm paranoid now. Fifty-five. What the hell? For those keeping track, this is on a different board. Oh yeah, let's try like, I don't know. Like I say, the only thing that could really affect it is extreme voltage. Okay. Okay. Okay, I'm happy. Oh no, it didn't apply. Ah, shit. What can I say? Okay, let's. Is this it? Are we switching to Ivy? I was able to set 1.9 V-core on Ivy, no problem. Should I put in an Ivy chip now? Okay, let me just try. Try to reason with this board one more time. It's just such a dumb thing, you know, like how can this possibly be a problem on two different boards? All right, 3570K. Hold on, did that apply somehow? No, okay. 3570K, oh dear. I never tried 2500K high V-core though, did I? Maybe just to satisfy all of my curiosities. No, 5770 for me. So that applied. It applied on this chip. What the hell? I don't really get it. It's a chip issue. It's a fucking chip issue. Yeah, it just applied 1.5 V core. Okay, let's just post 1.6 if we can. I know on ambient that's probably a little bit much, but I just want to make double sure that. Holy shit, that's. I need to sell that chip then. Yeah. I need to sell this chip to a non-bencher because. What the fuck? You learn something new every day in this hobby, I tell you that much.
Man, what an odyssey.
My thermal probe came loose. So we found one fucked chip and one board with one set of memory slots broken.
Yeah, I tried a 3770K, but it only went to 6.4. So I'm selling it. It's hard anyway to find a good enough sample of the top end chips, 4770K, 3770K. They were benched so much. I prefer the 50Ks, the 500Ks. It's a little bit more realistic to shoot for gold there. We may actually, I hesitate to say it, but we may actually be just about to start to do some benching. Miracles do happen. It may still scale horribly. It may take the V core, but it may still scale horribly. Don't worry. Plenty of ways this can still fail. More ways for it to fail than to succeed, I would say.
Doesn't want to do 52 multiplier for some reason. We're at minus 20. 2500K. So we determined that the problem with the vCore was a chip related issue because the chip wouldn't go above 1.45 vCore on either board. So now it's 2500K. And just sort of pulling down, figuring out shit. Making sure that minus 20 is actually a benchable temperature, let's say, and then going to OS at 1.6 vCore. Might have been just the memory setting I was trying to apply, to be honest. Let's go there again. Good night, Phil. Thanks for joining. Yeah, I'm just going to boot that. Minus 20. See how we go. What's up with this cam? Let's go 45. Okay, maybe the multiplier is just set a little bit too low. Let's determine what the highest multis we can post, and then sometimes in OS overclocking is a bit wonky. So yeah, because it's set to auto, so we go all core 38, whatever. We're at minus 28. That looks like a boot. Slowly getting there, guys. Can't rush these things. Let's do it. 6.3 gigahertz, here we come. Hi, Hive. Welcome, welcome. You just joined at the right moment. Things are just about to get exciting. Okay, now we can set the vCore. Sorry, the ratio. Okay, let's go 48. 48 is fine. Now let's go 50. Hang, okay. This is a known issue with his board, though. You've got to set over 50 post to be able to go over 50 boot. But let's just step it up and see what's happening here. Maybe a little bit too much vCore as well. A few things that could be going on. We're at minus 30. I am using a profile. I'm constantly saving it here, see? Okay, I was setting something else last time. Is there? Okay, that's looking better. Okay, where is the profile? Because okay. I see. Maybe I'll give that a try later. Okay. There we go. 52 is coming up. I'll give that a try later if I get stuck. I could at least load it to see what voltages he's applying. Okay. 54 should be no problem now. Okay. 55. All right. The big 56. All right. That's fine. Let's just give it a little bit of BCLK. And actually go up and molt as well. Yeah, 102 BCLK. Yeah, maybe PLLs and stuff is what he's setting. Who knows? Didn't like that. Quite cold at the moment though, minus 36. Now this is an IV profile though, you can tell from the BCL quake being so high. So he sets the power limits, he enables extreme voltage, he has CPU on auto, and he gives PLL a little bit more. Okay. So what's stock PLL actually? It's already at 1.7. See if you can boot 55 BCLK, 55 mod. Seems all right. See if you can do minus 40 without a hang or anything. So that's minus 40, still doing fine. Let's go BCLK first, see what happens there. So that's 5.55 at minus 46. And that's a hang. Okay. Next step will actually be just a little bit more V-core. So 50 millivolts. Because our temps are looking good. I didn't expect it to work this far down, to be honest. So a little bit more V-core, maybe even attempt to boot the 56 multiplier. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, Sandy is famous for not booting. So we're posting 5.6, but we're not booting it. So I'm happy to go a bit higher than that, considering our temps.
Maybe a bit colder as well.
Let's wait for it to get to minus 45. There we go. Now we're approaching minus 50. Okay. Down one and up one down here. Yeah, famous for being an ass. So this is practically 5.6. Yeah, and won't do it. It's okay. Approaching minus 55 now. Well, at least I didn't burn through lots of LN2 today. Some pace though. Yeah, maybe this is starting to be cold bug territory for this chip. Oh, I don't actually have a W prime 1024M run on this. Maybe I need to knock one out at 5.5 or something. And I should also try it with all cores. Yeah, let's actually just do a bench. Let's see if this will boot straight away and then do a W prime. That's a boot. It's always good. Yeah, it's just, what's a 2 minutes 40? I'm happy to burn some LN2 on a 2 minutes 40 W prime run. Five. Quick 32M just to get the juices flowing. And 10% at 17.6. So 2 minutes and 36. That'd be nice. I doubt it though. Percent at 40 seconds, so yeah, 2 minutes 40, that's seems very fast. Dagonzi, good morning. Well, it's 11:25 here right now, so we had Europeans staying up until 4 a.m. and now we have people in Europe getting up early as well, so constant flow of people coming into the chat. It's very nice. So where's our 50% point? Seconds. So that's more like a 2 minutes 45 pace now, which would still be very, very nice. Would be like a 40 pointer, but I doubt it. Just seems way too efficient. Feels good to actually be benching LN2 on stream. Yes, White Shark, you're a freak. Don't you have work or university or something to go to? I'm not judging though. I like to stay up late too, so. So here's the 2 minutes 40 mark. Yeah, I mean, obviously I can't compete with those other runs, but 2 minutes 50, 51, 52, 2 minutes, yeah, 2 minutes 55. So that's just off the front page. So efficiency seems all right. Okay. I mean, let's quickly grab it. It's not something that I'm proud of, but Corona, so no. So that was 175.328 prime. Yeah, it just doesn't want to go higher than that. Let's try multiplier next. Most productive at night. I know that excuse. Why is it not clocking as high as on Ambient? It's kind of weird. Let me check my bench notes about what vCore has said and stuff. Okay, still doesn't want to apply 56 ratio. Maybe I'm smashing too much vCore. Or maybe not enough. Why not? You only live once. What was that run at? Yeah, pretty much the same thing. No, it just... doesn't want to cooperate at all. Early AMD, so you mean Phenom 2? I go down in BCLK and up in BCLK, down in mold, up in BCLK, and just set DRAM voltage in case there's any issues there. Yeah, I mean, I've seen the YouTube clips. The idea here basically is to be able to still get to the 55x mult, but have a higher BCLK preset. Getting a revival. Are you saying AMD is gonna liquid helium the new stuff? The other idea, of course, would be to go colder. Okay. Maybe the chip has just degraded a little bit. Who knows? What are you teasing here, Keep? Spit it out or be forever silent. Oh, more Intel liquid helium. Exciting. That happens every generation. Not from the drive, but Rapid OC. Okay, let's try lower vCore. Let's see if we can find some sort of vCore sweet spot, and then we'll also check temps. Uh, 2000 series was good. I miss it. Okay, so let's go 53. Yeah, it just doesn't matter. It just doesn't. Okay. I'll go back to 1.7 and then just absolutely minimize the temps. Maybe that was being a bit too optimistic. Helium is expensive, man. Do you really want to spend all that money on something that just is consumable, just evaporates into thin air? Spend it on hardware instead. What 32 MW prime run do I have here actually? Five point four. Okay, I could do a better run there too. So -64 right now. Still okay. -70. -75. minus 80. All doesn't mean anything if it doesn't scale with temps. Minus 85. Minus 90. Ugh. Now, does it have a cold boot bug? Apparently not. That might have been a bit too much BCLK, so I will go back to 55x and 100. Or maybe just 54x. Well, no cold boot bug at minus 88. Let's go to minus 100. Well, I think it might be degrading. Yeah, it's not doing the 55x multiplier anymore. One more attempt on BCLK, and then I think I'll have to end the stream, given all the various issues. Okay, well, it's always nice to try an architecture on LN2 just to confirm that it's really crap on LN2. Okay, let's do minus 100. That's minus 100, nice. Okay, and that's probably the cold bug. At about minus 105. Even though it is rebooting, yeah, that's looking like a cold bug now. Well, I wanted to try both chips on cold and. Clearly, I degraded, probably degraded both of them to, in some way, in my ambient testing. Expected result, but still disappointing. Yeah. That might have to be the end. I'll try and run off another W prime as I'm pulling up, but there you go. Conclusion is don't run Sandy on cold. I don't know how these people got 6.3 out of theirs, but it does, definitely seems to be a dark art. Okay, let's see if I have LN2 left next week. I probably will have, and I'll run something fun like Ivy or some sort of full pot platform, maybe Ryzen first gen. But yeah, lots of people on stream today. No tech issues, no drop frames, but the bench rig is acting a bit weird to say the least. All right, until next time. See you then.